Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. On Thursday, SpaceX launched the OneWeb 17 mission on a Falcon 9 rocket.
One, full power, and liftoff, OneWeb 3.
The booster which launched this mission, B-1062, then landed successfully for the 13th time on the landing pad at Landing Zone 1.
Flight termination system is safe for stage 1. You can see those attitude control thrusters on the first stage firing there.
Both vehicles continue to follow nominal trajectories.
Those first and second stages are looking good. And our next milestone is the Stage 1 landing burn, which is coming all the way back to Landing Zone 1 in Cape Canaveral, starting in about 15 seconds here.
Stage 1 transonic.
Stage 2 FTSS saved.
Stage 1 landing burn.
Start of our Stage 1 landing burn. Great drone footage of the first stage that you can see on the right-hand side of your screen. Incredible views from first stage coming down on
stage
landing
one, land and land deploy.
That was a beautiful landing. Beautiful landing of the first stage, and there you have it. That landing marks
stage two is in terminal guidance.
That landing marks SpaceX's 177th recovery of an orbital class rocket, including the first stage landings of Falcon 9 and Heavy.
Coming up this week, we can hopefully expect a few launches with the next Dragon mission in just a few days. The CRS-27 mission is currently scheduled to lift off on Wednesday 15th at 12:30 a.m. UTC or Tuesday 14th at 8:30 p.m. EDT. Following that, on the same day, we can hopefully expect to see a Starlink mission launch. The Starlink 28 mission is currently scheduled for liftoff on Wednesday 15th at 6:18 p.m. UTC or 2:18 p.m. EDT. Then, later in the week, we can hopefully expect to see another Falcon 9 mission. The SES-18 and SES-19 mission is currently scheduled for Saturday 18th at 12:35 a.m. UTC or Friday 17th at 8:35 p.m. EDT. I want to share this cool image posted by Elon Musk on Twitter of the Falcon 9 which launched OneWeb and landed on LZ-1. Thomas Burchhart posted a tweet related to SpaceX's Landing Zone 1 and 2 pads. He said, SpaceX appears to be ending their use of landing zones 1 and 2 in the not-too-distant future. The astronauts of the Crew 5 mission have now returned home. NASA posted this tweet saying the four members of NASA's SpaceX Crew 5 mission are back on Earth wrapping up a 157-day 2500 orbit ISS research-packed trip to the space station. Heading to Boca Chica, this new Starship lifting rig was seen being tested. This test nose cone was seen rolling to Massey's test site. Greg Scott posted a cool shot of work going on at Roberts Road on tower sections for tower number 3. There was an interesting article posted that I want to share. It says Los Angeles-based startup K2 Space, co-founded by brothers Karan and Neil Kunja, is setting out to build satellite buses to leverage new large rockets such as SpaceX's Starship. The Starship 28 nose cone was seen being lifted for stacking. Booster 7 was recently lifted off of the orbital launch mount for the first time in a while. Here's a view of the actual lift taking place. It was also moved a bit away from the orbital launch mount. As always, I have to say thank you to Nick Ansuini for being out there filming the Boca Chica content. Also, thank you to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.